I got my start in casting because one day, scrolling through Twitter, surfing that web, it said, do you think you got what it takes to cast alongside Gears Esports casters? Being the guy that I am, I said, the worst they can tell me is no. So I immediately rang up a buddy of mine because I'm a bit technologically illiterate. And I said, you got to tell me how I download programs, what mic I got to figure out how to use, and how in the world do I download this whole raw footage gameplay thing? He sat down for a few hours. He walked me through it like a five-year-old. I started to record over the gameplay. I did about one take on the actual gameplay, and then I did two or three side station interviews that I kind of mocked up over in front of a blank side of my white wall, and we sent it in, and I said, you know, I'm probably never, ever going to hear from these people again. And then about 3.5 weeks later, I got an email from the one, the only Guy Blaze Live, inviting me to be a part of the broadcast team for Gears Esports MLG New Orleans that was also in conjunction with Halo that weekend. And it went from being a fan to an overexcited fan who was hopefully about to shout out loud over a whole lot of professional players.
I got my start in casting actually well before I even got my first shot professionally. I was throughout playing in my Gears of War career, I just wanted to kind of do something different. Throughout growing up, I always got told, you know, disturbing others in class. I always got in trouble for talking too much, so it kind of came naturally. One day, I actually got hit up by fellow resident Gears esports caster Guy Blaze because he kind of saw me doing my own things on the side. 18 or 2017 is when I got my first shot at Dallas on the main stage with Blaze, Benson, even Veli at his first event. And then from there, the rest is history.
Casting Gears Esports has brought quite a bit to me, honestly. Again, it brought me a new home, a home that I feel comfortable in. I love the community as it is. The pros are great. The competition is incredible. The action is palpable. And Gears brings all of that in one nice package. And I gotta say, there is no community like it, and I've been a part of a lot of them. I'm still a part of several different gaming communities, but Gears, there's nothing like it. It really is truly my home.
Gears Esports has brought some of the most awesome people into my life, between friends and competitors. Throughout all the events I've been to over the years and all the traveling which we've done, we have created some awesome moments that we have only experienced by being a part of Gears Esports.
I knew I wanted to make casting a career. I kid you not, the very first time I ever commentated, there was just something magical about it. It was only to 9 viewers, but those 9 viewers were listening to what I had to say. They were listening to the story that I had to tell. Granted, the players are the ones who are in the story. They're the main characters, if you will, but I am the storyteller, the narrator. There's nothing like that, at least from what I've done. And I've done a lot of things in my life, but there's nothing like commentary. So literally the very first time I ever commentated, I said, this is the job that I want with my life. And I've been in love with it ever since. It's almost been a decade and it's never gotten old.
You know, I always wanted casting to be a career, but I could never fathom it. Not until 2016, when Gears Esports blew up on the scene once again in Gears of War 4, announcing an inaugural $1 million pro circuit. That was the day that I knew I got a chance to make it here, and I grabbed that chance by the horns, and hey, we're still here now. We're riding a bull, and casting has been a dream come true.
A defining moment for when I knew I wanted this to be a career? That's easy. We were standing in the middle of Mexico City, and I had a couple of people come up to me. People I had never met, never spoken to, didn't know from Adam and Eve. And they made the comment that me casting over some of these games, having to hear those words, help them to better understand not just the game type, personalities behind the players, and the grandiose of the situation in front of them. I took one look at them and it made me realize it was a light bulb going off that players define moments, moments defined by words. And it was now my job, and possibly one day it'll be my legacy, to cast over some of the best moments in Gears Esports. And I knew right then and there I was going to give it all I got for as long as they'll have me.
Raise your voice.
Raise your voice.
Raise your voice.
Raise your voice.